Hello students, hope you are doing great. So today's topic of discussion is recommender system. Recommender system is a part of machine learning and it is the well-known or most widely used technique of machine learning. So in this lecture we are going to cover some of the topics related to recommender system, just like what is recommender system, what are different techniques of recommender system, what is content based, what is collaborative filtering, what is hybrid filtering, and what are the limitations of these already existing recommendation techniques. So I have prepared this lecture by taking some of the contents from different sources, so there is no objection while giving the credit to the original contributor. Fine, so let's understand how many data is available over the internet and why there is a need of recommender system. So here in this slide you can see there are 1 minute data which is generated over the internet. In the left hand side is this 2018 data, and it is on the right hand side it is the data of 2019. Okay, so what happens in just a minute over the internet? So you can see over here 3.7 million search queries were made on the Google alone in 2018, where in 2019 3.8 million search queries were made. So here you can see there is this slight jump, and in Facebook in 2018 973,000 logins were made, but if you see in 2019 it's reached to 1 million. In the same way 18 million texts were made in 2018, but it jumps to 18.1 million in 2019. And if I talk about the YouTube, it is 4.3 million views in 2018, but in 2019 it is 4.5. so if you observe all of these applications of the internet, you can see and you know that by going through year by year, the use of data, use of internet is increasing day by day. What is happening? What is the actual problem? So the actual problem is that there are plenty of data present to be accessed, means there are a lot of data available over the internet, abundance of information available for users, and number of internet users increasing drastically. As you can see, if you talk about the digital India, everybody is having the internet right now. So in the rural areas, the user are creating their account on the Facebook, on the Google or other social networking websites or other online websites. So it means the users are increasing drastically. So there are a lot of information, lot of data is available. So how a online user is going to handle such information? So what is this problem? This is problem of information overload. So what a information overload precisely? If I say a user is having too much information that he or she is not able to make any decision from it, is the problem of information overload. Let's take an example of Amazon. If you go for Amazon, if there is only one product is available of Samsung mobile, then you can easily avail that particular model. But let's suppose if there is 10 different models of the same specifications, then there is a confusion. So the confusion that arises while there are different models is the confusion is known as the information overload. You are overloaded with different information, right? So what is the solution to deal with this information is the use of a recommender system. So what a recommender system is? A recommender system is a software filtering technique that attempts to present information or the items. What are the items? Just like movies, the music, the books, news, images and different things to the user based on the user's past or preference, preferred items in the past, right? So whatever the user have preferred in the past, the similar items will be recommended in the future. So what are different examples of recommender system? See, if you are on online, you are surrounded by the recommender system. Just take an example of Amazon. There is a recommendations of the products, of the items. If you go on the LinkedIn, there is a recommendations of the post or the recommendation of the job. If you go on the Netflix, there is a recommendation of the movies, right? You will see that which one is the next upcoming movie and which one is the most likely movie that you are going to like or prefer to watch, right? In the last.fm, it will be a music. In the Google News, it is a news. In the Flipkart or in the Snapdeal, everywhere, the phenomena of recommender system comes into the picture. So there is a saying, in modern age, you don't find the product finds you. So what exactly the recommender system is? A recommender system is nothing but a technique which suggests a particular item. The item can be movie, music, or the news, or can be image, to a particular user based on his past experiences. So whatever you have experienced in the past, the similar kind of things will be recommended in your future. So why there is a need of recommendations? Means, what is the advantage of recommendations? If you see, Netflix, 2/3 movies are watched based on the recommendations. So whatever the recommendations are made, based on those recommendations, user watch the movie. For the Google News, recommendations generate 38% more clicks. 38%. In Amazon, the 35% sales from the recommendations. You might have seen on the Amazon, they give the recommendations. Like if you buy this one, also buy this one. So there is combination. Like, so there is similarity between the items. Or if you have preferred this one, you can also prefer this one, right? Or the people buy this one, they also bought this one, right? So these are the statistics which proves that a recommendation system plays very important role in our life. So what are different application areas? As I said earlier, recommendations plays a role, its role everywhere. From Facebook to the e-commerce website, just like Flipkart or Amazon or Snapdeal, or to the matrimonial websites, to the hotel preference websites, or everywhere. I think the recommendation system is working everywhere in the online portal, right? So how the data is represented behind the recommendation systems? You might have seen when you buy some item from the online website, just like Amazon, you might have seen that they will ask you about your feedback. They will ask, so at what extent do you like this particular product? So if you give 1 star, it means this is the fair product. And if you give the 5 star, it means it is extraordinary. So it shows your likelihood for a particular item. So if you give 5 star, a 5 will be put in a two-dimensional matrix where the rows represents the users and the column represents the items. So there are some set of users which is represented by C, and there is some set of items which is represented by S, right? And there is some ratings. Rating is R. So if you give 4 rating, it means the 4-star rating will be represented by 4. And if you don't give anything, it will be null. So in this matrix, you can see that the rows are Alice, Bob, and the columns are the Capex, Life of Brian. So it represents that how Alice liked this particular movie Capex. It's 4. 4 means high likelihood, right? So this is a two-dimensional matrix is built behind this recommendation system.